Hello dear students, welcome in this maths class. Let's solve this question. The question is, which of the following pair of linear equations has unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solutions? In case there is a unique solution, find it by using cross multiplication method. So first part is given this. So first of all, we should know what is the general form of pair of linear equations in two variables. So this is general form a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, and then a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So here if a1 over a2 does not equal to b1 over b2, then there is unique solution. Then pair of lines or pair of linear equations have unique solution, means lines are intersecting these and the intersecting point is the solution of this pair of linear equations. So it will be a unique solution, and when it is a1 over a2 is equal to b1 over b2 is equal to c1 over c2, then in this case there are infinitely many solutions. These lines are coincident lines and it will have, this pair will have many solutions. So, and the third option is when a1 over a2 is equal to b1 over b2 but does not equal to c1 over c2, then there is no solution. There is no solution because lines are parallel here in this case. So first of all, we have to find for each part this option. And if it is a unique solution, then we will find with the help of cross multiplication method. So let's start the question. So on comparing with the general form of pair of linear equations in two variables, here a1 is here 1, b1 is minus 3 and c1 is minus 3. And then a2 is 3, b2 is minus 9 and c2 is here minus 2. So first of all, we'll find out a1 over a2. So it is 1 over 3. So let's find out b1 over b2. B1 over b2, it is minus 3 over minus 9. Minus minus cancel, 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9, that is 1 by 3. See here, a1 over a2 here is equal to b1 over b2. Let's find c1 over c2. C1 over c2, that is minus 3 over minus 2. Minus minus cancel, it is 3 by 2. So we'll write, since a1 over a2 is equal to b1 over b2, because these are 1 by 3, 1 by 3, but does not equal to c1 over c2. So this pair of linear equations have no solution. So this pair of linear equations have no solution. Now let's do the second part. So this is 2x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. In question it was 2x plus y is equal to 5. So I brought this 5 to left hand side to make it into standard form. So here 8 was in this side, so I brought this 8 in this side, left hand side. So here a1 is, right here, a1 is 2, b1 is 1 and c1 is minus 5. Then a2 is here 3, b2 is 2 and c2 is minus 8. So let's find out a1 over a2. So a1 over a2 is equal to 2 over 3. Now here b1 over b2, that is 1 by 2. So these are not equal. We will need not to find out c1 over c2 because these are not equal. So we'll write, since a1 over a2 does not equal to b1 over b2, so this pair of linear equations have unique solution. So we'll find this unique solution by cross multiplication method. So in cross multiplication method, first of all we'll write here x, here y and here 1. Now we'll start writing the coefficients here of these x and y and then constant terms here. So what we do, we'll start from the coefficients of y. So it is 1 and 2. Here minus 5, then minus 8. Then it is 2, then it is 3. So suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So we'll start from 2. 2, 3, 1, 2. We will follow this order here. 2, 3, 1, 2. Again, I repeat here 2, 3, 1, 2. So let's write. It is 1 and 2. So we'll write below x 1 and 2. Here minus 5 and minus 8. Here 2 and 3. Here 1 and here 2. So now we'll do cross multiply. See here how. We'll write here x over something is equal to y over something, we'll write here later on, is equal to 1 over something. So below x, what we do, we'll do cross multiply. This multiply by this minus this multiply by this. So it becomes 1 into minus 8. So we'll write directly minus 8 minus this into this means 2 into minus 5. This is below 8. Now below y, minus 5 into 3, minus 5 into 3, minus, minus 8 into 2, or you can write 2 into minus 8, right? Now here below 1, 2 into 2, minus 3 into 1, that is 3 only. So this way, now let's see what will be there. X over, it is minus 8 and minus 2 into minus 5 is plus 10. Is equal to y over minus 5 into 3 minus 15. Minus 2 minus 8 is plus 16. Is equal to 1 over 2 to the 4 minus 3. That is 1 at C. So now we can do here. So it is x over minus 8 plus 10. Sorry, we can write here plus 2. Now I'll write here next line. X over here minus 8 plus 10 is plus 2 is equal to y over minus 15 plus 16, that is plus 1, then 1 over 4 minus 3 is 1. So 1 by 1 we will equate x over 2 with 1 by 1, then y over 1 with 1 by 1. So we can get the values of x and y from here. So first of all we will have x over 2 is equal to 1 by 1, and here we will have y over 1 is equal to 1 by 1. So from here x is equal to 2 and from here y is equal to 1. So x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is the unique solution of this pair of linear equations. So let's do the third part. So this is our third part. So first of all we'll write this into standard form, or you can say like this way, multiplies. We'll bring 20 to left hand side and 40 also to left hand side. So it becomes 3x minus 5y minus 20 is equal to 0. And then 6x minus 10y minus 40 is equal to 0. Here a1 is here 3. b1 is here minus 5. And c1 is here minus 20. So here a2 is 6. B2 is minus 10, C2 is minus 40. So let's find out what is A1 over A2. So A1 over A2 is equal to 3 over 6, that is 1 by 2. B1 over B2, let's see. B1 over B2, that is minus 5 over minus 10. That is also, I think, it is 1 by 2. Let's find out C1 over C2, that is minus 20 over minus 40, minus minus cancel. So it is, you can say 1 by 2. So since A1 over A2 is equal to B1 over B2 is equal to C1 over C2, then there are infinitely many solutions. These pair of linear equations are coincident. So we'll write there are many solutions. So A1 over A2 is equal to B1 over B2 is equal to C1 over C2. So this pair of linear equations have infinitely many solutions. So fourth part students can do themselves. So this way we can solve these questions. Thanks for watching.